Hello and welcome to Mutual of Omaha's Wild Kingdom, brought to you by Mutual of Omaha. Oh, wrong show. Sorry about that. Welcome to the Manufactured Home Show, everybody. It is Wednesday, hump day, April the 5th. Oh, no, April the 6th. Pardon me. 2011. Welcome to the show. We're going to have the soundtrack once again, the beatbox. I don't know if you can hear that, but if you hear a little music in the background, that's it. Our proud sponsor is not Mutual of Omaha. It's manufacturedhomemart.com. Everybody knows that. Good morning. Let's get right to it, shall we? Now, as I said before, yesterday, we're going to focus more on manufactured housing. Imagine that on the Manufactured Home Show. Now, I want to talk about all these home shows, and I want to be specific about them, and I'm basically plugging them for free, which is okay because it's all part of the business, really. And I am amazed that these things just trounce right on top of each other in terms of the dates, but particularly when it comes to the National Congress and Expo. But I know that those things are hard to book. I found that out by poking around. But needless to say, it's unfortunate. I'm sure people, especially people like me, who really want to cover a broad base, a national base, it's hard to be in so many places. And anyway, let me give the plugs for these shows. I think it's very important for the industry. So we've got the Home Expo 2011, that's happening in York, Pennsylvania. It's April 26th through the 28th. Those are the trade days. And then the public days are April 29th through May 1st. For more information about that, go to pmha.org or pahomeexpo.com. Now, the Great Southwest Home Show, interestingly enough, is exactly the same time. But obviously, York, Pennsylvania, Oklahoma, very far from each other. So we're talking about regional stuff. I can see that. So we're okay. MHAO.org for the Great Southwest Home Show. That's April 28th for the trade day. And then April 29th through May 1st for the public days. And let's not forget, okay, here's the one that people have to make a choice. So the MHI, the National Congress and Expo, is April 26th through April 28th. For more information about the National Congress, go to congressandexpo.com. Now, the big difference between this is that you're talking about manufactured home shows that actually have homes there. The home shows are for that. Great Southwest Home Show or Home Expo. If you want to see homes, you're going there. But if you're part of the industry, it's likely that you may wind up at the conference, which is in Las Vegas. So there you go. Manufactured housing hits the very beginning of the Manufactured Home Show. I knew I could do it. Let's talk about something else, though. Okay, so the breaking news today is that, first of all, they're trying to solve the budget crisis. And so they're talking about the fact that the government could shut down. Well, does that mean anything? Not really. It really doesn't. Essential services are going to be there. So the air traffic controllers, of course, the national security is all going to be in place. I was reading about this. The Postal Service will continue to operate. Okay, but it could slow some things down. You might not be able to get a passport. Your National Park Service could be closed, and national museums and monuments. Oh no. National Institutes of Health, they'll stop accepting clinical research patients. You know, basically there's going to be no effect. But I guess what I really want to say is, please pull it together, President and Congress. It's very embarrassing what's going on in the United States right now. I have to say that I love Jesse Ventura. I wanted to mention it yesterday, how great is the former governor of Minnesota, Jesse Ventura, and a very brave guy. P- Piers Morgan had him on the show on CNN a couple days ago, and the very next day, which was yesterday, he was on Howard Stern, which I didn't know that. And I did listen to that part, only a small part, but Jesse Ventura is an amazing American. The guy's got a lot of guts to say the things that he says. Unless anyone, if anybody thinks he's crazy, the man's not crazy. That's for sure. I think he's very intelligent. Could be a little bit eccentric about some things, that's for sure. But certainly a guy that is rooted in sanity, which is more than I can say for a lot of the people in our government right now. Now, speaking of which, I thought this was interesting. The Dish Network is in on this bidding for Blockbuster. And I'm bummed out about that because this is getting crazy with these guys. But I'm telling you, there are big dollars at hand. I should have got involved in that business instead of manufactured housing. Okay, so don't worry too much, everybody, about the government shutdown. I don't think that's a big deal. AT&T taking over T-Mobile is more of a big deal. Got the duopoly with the mobile services. I mean, it's going to be Sprint's going to just go away if AT&T gets it. We talked about that. Okay, I'm sorry. I had to deviate from the manufactured homes just for a moment to talk about things of the day. I see on the front of MSNBC.com, they got these poor kids that are just going back to school, and they're just sitting there in the nuclear fallout zone. I'm feeling for these people in Japan. That is an unbelievable disaster that has happened over there. And they've just been scrambling ever since the earthquake and tsunami to get control of that situation. God help those people over there. We got to keep praying and keep giving to the Red Cross. Oh my goodness. Okay. I wanted to talk a little bit about my home state of Arizona. As I was looking through, you know, Arizona has some home shows in the past, but I guess they're not doing it. It's probably due to budget constraints. And I'm sure our trade association for manufactured housing here in Arizona needs people and money. They also need a new website, but that's neither here nor there at this time. But I'm praying and giving my support for the state of Arizona. I'm not a member at this time. But my dad, who owns a retailership here in Arizona, Blackhawk Homes, he is a member, and I hope that people will start to look to him to be a leader, because that's the type of guy he is. He definitely belongs in there. I'm not joining AHA because I think that it's not really good for my business at this point because of the way that I'm doing things. And but it's good for people who are retailers, communities. I'd like to see more communities get involved with that. But certainly the State of Arizona Association can use support. And their website is azhousing.org for professional members here in Arizona. Join in there and see if you can help out and get things going for our state association. Get things going. It's pretty tough. I try not to get too political, but you know, it is a webcast. It is a show, and I do like to introduce my viewpoints, even though I get concerned that they might not be popular with some people. But I think if you're gonna do something like this, you might as well go ahead and throw stuff out there. Just a vanilla type webcast does not cut it. But I'm not a fan of people like Jan Brewer, who's our governor, Sheriff Joe, Maricopa County Sheriff, or Russell Pierce, who God only knows what he's. I don't know what his problem is, but these people have an agenda here in Arizona that makes me very nervous. It also makes us look like backwards hillbillies, which I'd like to say that not everybody in Arizona is that way. There are some good free thinking people. However, problem is that there's a whole lot of sheep over here in Arizona, and they go back to the red side, the Republicans. Now, I've said on this show, and I'll repeat myself, I'm not a Democrat, I'm not a Republican. I'm the most independent free thinker that you'll find. And so when I put my viewpoints out there, I'm not coming from the left or the right. I just try to go with what I think is the correct way to go. So, I even tweeted about this. I said, you know, and this was inspired by Jesse Ventura, as I was talking about before. The two-party system is killing us here. Look at what's going on right now. We can't even pass a budget. So anyway, I guess I got off on a little bit of a tangent. But listen, point being is that there's got to be people that will go to the center. There has to be another party for the United States, maybe a couple more. The power base of Democrats and Republicans is screwing us up, and we got to get some new leadership in there. Now, it's going to be very difficult to do because some big, big players that hold all the gold are pulling the strings for everybody. So we need to get past the smoke and mirrors of what's happening with our government right now. People need to get involved. So it's more than, this is a type of thing where we get bigger than just manufactured housing. And that's why it's hard for me to just only reserve my comments to the industry I'm in. There's a great big world out there. Right now, really, our own country needs our help. So people, let's pay attention to what's happening. I think we've got some major, major issues, and our leadership is not is not getting it done. So we need to be more open to new things, to new ideas, and let's see if we can get some things done for real in government. I think everybody agrees there's too much government. And we're all over the world chasing down Libyans and terrorists and doing all kinds of stuff. I think calmer heads are going to have to prevail here. We need to really think about what we're doing. Might be the end of the world, you know. Anyway, listen, I'm sorry for getting so deep today. It's always fun. You know, I had the phone number up in case anybody wanted to chime in to challenge my positions. Look, you can't see it on the recorded show, but there's the phone. Phone number is pushed up today, so nobody called in to argue with me. So that must mean that I'm right. Anyway, listen, I'm going to get out of here. I'm seeing that I'm approaching 15 minutes, so boredom set in for you, the viewer, at least 12 minutes ago, I would say. So listen, thanks for hanging out for the show. We'll be back tomorrow for more enlightenment, more opinions, more fun. And tomorrow will be the Thursday show. Getting towards Friday, everybody. Have a great day. Thank you for joining us for the Manufactured Home Show. Go to manufacturedhomemart.com, our proud sponsor for everything that has to do with manufactured homes, buying, selling, premier online store for manufactured housing and modular. Manufacturedhomemart.com. Oh, you're just in time to say goodbye.
Goodbye.
Would you like to show your pretty face? Ladies and gentlemen, my wife. Bye-bye.